Recall that for one-dimensional differential equations, we formed a phase line, and this lets us summarize the behavior of all solutions to the equation. We see anything between 0 and 100 goes up to 100, anything bigger than 100 goes down, and so on. So what I'd like to do next is generalize this idea of a phase line to two dimensions. So as before, here are the solutions to the Lotka-Volterra equation. There are two solutions because we're keeping track of two different things, the rabbits and the foxes. So if it was a one-dimensional situation and we just had rabbits growing, logistically perhaps, we would just have a one-dimensional phase line because there's one thing to keep track of, rabbits. Now there are two, and so we'll plot this on a phase plane. So what I'm going to do is take the rabbit population and plot them against the fox population. So I'm going to remove time, just like we did when we made the one-dimensional phase lines. So let me show you what this would look like for this solution. So if I plot the red curve against the blue curve, I end up with this cycle. And I think it's easiest to make sense of this by talking through this cycle using rabbit and fox stories, as I did here. So, all right. So let's start here in the lower left. This is the rabbit axis. This is how many rabbits there are in tons of rabbits. This is how many tons of foxes there are, or something like that. We start down here. Rabbits are small. Foxes are small. The populations are small. And so that's good news for the rabbits. The rabbits like it when there aren't too many foxes. So the rabbit population increases. Moving to the right on this diagram means that the rabbit populations are increasing. As the rabbit populations increase, the fox population starts to increase as well. Moving up on this diagram, up on this phase plane, means that fox population is getting larger. So the fox population is getting larger and larger and larger. And here, the rabbit population starts decreasing. Rabbit population is decreasing because we're moving to the left. I should probably put some arrows on here to make it clearer which way the motion is. Okay. So we move this way. And then the rabbit population starts to decrease, but the fox population is still increasing. Why? Because we're going up. This curve is moving up in the fox direction, in the y direction. So the rabbits are decreasing, but the foxes are still increasing until we get to here. And here the fox population starts to crash because there aren't enough rabbits and we're starting to have hungry foxes again. So in this segment of the graph, the fox population is decreasing. The rabbit population decreases a little more. Then we have this sharp, sharp drop in the fox population. Rabbits are more or less constant. And then we begin again. So we could put arrows on this, just like we put arrows on the phase line. And we know that the population will cycle around like this. It doesn't tell us that the time information. We don't know how long it will take to cycle around. It could take one time unit, 10, or 100. We lose that information when we go to a phase plane, just like we lose time information when we go to a phase line in one dimension. So I hope it's at least that the story that I told about the cycle here is familiar. In fact, it's the same story that I told here when we're tracking these two together. Let's see, let me mention one more way to look at this. If we think just in terms of the foxes, if we ignore the rabbits, that's sort of like maybe imagining we're compressing this in or something, the foxes go down to about 1 and their maximum is about 11. And that's what we see here. The foxes go down to about 1 and up to about 11. It won't look quite the same because the scales are different, but if I wanted to look at the rabbits, well, I'll keep it this way. The rabbits go down to a little bit less than 1, and they their maximum value is a little bit less than 11. So rabbits are right always between these two values. And that's what we see here. The rabbits go down to less than 1, almost a half, and their maximum is a little bit less than 11. So again, to summarize, we took two solution curves, f as a function of time and r for rabbits as a function of time, and we plotted them against each other. In so doing, we lose the time information, but we're able to see, I think, much more clearly how the rabbit and fox populations, how they cycle together, and how those cycles are related. In the next unit, I'll do a few more examples of curves in phase space, and I'll talk a little bit more generally about the sorts of solutions we can see and can't see in two dimensions. So that'll be in the next subunit.